So Gary, I see you're one of those totally self-sufficient guys. What made you get into that? What happened in your life?
Well, 14 years ago, I started bleeding out of my bowels, and as I started healing myself and getting better, I realized that my food supply was critical to my health. And so what happened was I decided one day to start going back to the way I was raised in growing and harvesting food from the wild. And I told my wife that we're going to start growing everything in our backyard, in my Etobicoke home. And so I started doing everything myself. And the more I did myself, the better my body felt.
And you just taught yourself this, or did you have previous experience?
Well, I had some previous experience because my grandmother as a kid started me, because we're Native background, we're Native.
Oh,
so
cool.
We used to live off the land totally.
Wow.
And so my parents, as we got older, they had more money and a little bit better jobs. They stopped doing everything ourselves, and basically, you know, I ate junk food like everybody else. And then running my automotive business, you know, the coffee truck rolls in, you don't have time to take care of yourself or make a nice meal or cook real food or eat real food in the first place. You know, as time gets on, I started degenerating and having back pains and problems. And to me, you know, when the doctors would kept telling me my spine was degenerating and they wanted to cut me open and look inside of me, I kept asking them, look for what? They couldn't give me any chronicle dictated proper answers. They suspected I had Crohn's, which is incurable, colitis, which is incurable, and if you're passing blood, they usually suspect you got some form of cancer. So I just didn't feel proper with these guys, you know, telling me, but they couldn't show me. And I saw my x-rays before the doctors did. I saw my scans before the doctors did. I drank barium dye, and I saw my teeth and my rectum on the same slides. I mean, I went through crap that I didn't have to. So my food supply became imperative to me. I thought, well, what happens when winter comes? So I started drawing stuff and learning how to do stuff, even though I didn't have my mother right there to teach me some of the stuff, because she didn't even really learn most of it from her grandmother. So I did research. I had a basic foundation of growing plants and harvesting from the wild. I was hunting at 10 years old in the bush. I was, you know, putting pheasants and partridge in the freezer. I was cleaning deer at 15. I was doing this stuff with my father and my mother. You know, I was raised around it. So when you start to really pay attention to animals and see what they eat, how they react, what they do in the forest, they teach you. And then because I came from a kind of a religious background, if you want to say that, my parents read the Bible, especially my mother. You know, I read statements as a kid in the Bible that Job said, you know, why is it only you that has wisdom? Look at the animals, they will teach you. Look at the birds, they will teach you.
Wow.
Look at the sea will teach you. You know, look at the earth will teach you. Well, as a native person sitting in the forest, I saw that's reality, that's actual fact. You know, you pay attention, you see things, and they teach you what's going on. So you see different animals eating certain things, and, you know, they're not dying from it, so you go and you taste it. So, you know, different cultures that I ran into through my automotive business, different people, I'd say, well, what did you eat as a child? You're 75 years old, you look in good health, what did you eat? And they would explain to me. So then I started looking around the earth everywhere and noticing that we all ate rice, bread, or beans in some form. We all ate some fish, meat, eggs, right, in some form. So we're all human beings. So why was I so sick? So then it boiled back down to what I was putting in my mouth, and I couldn't blame God or the devil or my neighbor because I was the one holding the fork. So I basically started really examining my food supply and really realizing that I was in control of my destiny. And the more I took care of my food supply, the better and healthier I would keep myself, and my longevity would increase or my health would go up. So I started examining this, and the more I examined it, I started realizing that it wasn't as hard to keep my food supply as I thought it was. It became simpler and simpler and simpler because most to the free food and medicine existed in the weeds. You're growing a garden, the dandelions grow up faster in your garden, the plantain grows up faster in your garden, the milk thistle is there, the bull thistle is there. You know, you have lamb's quarters, you have purslane, they all try to take over your garden. Well, when I started investigating all these plants and remembering that my grandmother wouldn't make soup without lamb's quarters or dandelion leaves or plantain, I mean, I started asking my mother questions, and she said, oh yeah, yeah, your grandmother did this stuff. I said, well, Mom, why don't you do it? Oh, I was just too lazy. I didn't feel, I didn't have the interest.
Too westernized.
It was just easy to go to the store and buy something.
Yeah.
So, but looking at backwards, you know, my mother, for example, when she was sick, she used to call me her doctor because I was helping her cook real food and she felt good. When the doctors were treating her, she was feeling bad. So she started realizing she should have studied more of this stuff and done more of it. So this is stuff that entered into my life, and I really took care of paying attention to what I was eating and then how easy it was to have a food supply. And then what happened was I went to a beekeeper to pick up some raw honey that I deal with downtown. I like his product. And I'm in the process of having my own beehives right now on this little farm I bought, because I want to have my own supply, even then making my food bill even cheaper. And some gentleman told me that the health show was on, and then when I went there that Saturday morning, somebody grabbed me by the arm and said, hey, you gotta listen to this guy, Tom. He talks like you do about the plants. And I said, nobody talks about me about the plants like I do. And that's when I heard Marcus Rothgren speaking, and I introduced myself to him. And then basically, a few months later, I got an email that said, would you like to make a movie? And I thought it was a joke. I didn't remember Marcus in that. And I wrote, anytime you're ready. And then basically he showed up and said, I want to film you. And this was what happened, the results of it.
This is what? This is a video?
It's a workshop of about 6 hours of me teaching people about wild vegetables that grow around anybody's yard, almost everywhere on the earth. You can find most of these plants and trees. And you can use them to help heal yourself, get real minerals and vitamins from them, and make your body feel whole again. Improve your digestion, your mental attitude.
So when did this get released?
Last year, November.
Wow. So what are people saying about it?
I haven't had a negative comment at all. I've had naturopathic doctors with master degrees in science that are writing for syndicated columns in the United States. I've watched it 10 times from start to finish. They listen to the audio part every time they drive to work in their car. They're sending me emails asking me questions about when I should pick the plants and what I can use, the many recipes I have, nutritional skills about it. And I'm teaching them, and sometimes I feel very humbled and honored at the same time that these people with such backgrounds and diplomas, just little old me from the bush, is teaching them how to really live more sustainably.
Well, let's talk about your own personal living sustainably. Like, what's your food bill?
It's less than $30 a week for four people all year round.
What?
It's less than $30 a week for four people all year round.
How's that?
Well, when you calculate out what the average person spends, they're mostly buying junk. They're not really eating real food.
So functional food.
For example, I do grow a vegetable garden, so I have my own potatoes, tomatoes, carrots, beans, squash, gourds, pumpkins, and I do that stuff, but you can't just eat that. So there's natural herbs and spices that grow outside everywhere on the earth, so I gather them in their type of season. For example, if I'm going to make a roast with some beef or a stew, traditional native culture, I pick red pine cones when I go in the forest at this time of the year. The red squirrel does the work for me. He goes up to the top of the tree, cuts them off, knocks them on the ground, and I just walk around with a basket picking them up, and he screams at me and gives a little noise, but I watch him eating them. And I'm not a red squirrel to get all the little nutlet seeds out of the tiny cone, but when you put them in hot water and cook them with your food, the essential fatty acids, the omega-3s and the omega-6 comes out of the pine nuts, and now it goes in with the stew broth, and then when you eat that warm soup with your meat and your vegetables that you've cooked, you're getting these essential fats from the pine.
So you have to buy from fish or other sources, which is more expensive.
Yes, so you're getting those essential oils, and if you look at a pine cone, it's shaped exactly like your pineal gland.
Yes.
And because it's shaped like that, if you look at homeopathy, like cures like. So that stimulates pineal gland to produce more hormones to help your body regulate better and feel better.
Smart thinking. Wow. We can go on and on and on, but we're just kind of limited with our time. To find out more information, what's your website?
It's GaryTibbo.com, www.GaryTibbo.com. And my name is spelled GarryTibbo.
Excellent.
And my email address is just Gary@GaryTibbo.com.
Great. Thank you so much. Quite the self-sufficient guy.